Hello friends, so I'm going ahead with a new series in which I'm going to cover all the application overview for higher studies. So I know I'm going a bit away from my topic of mechanical engineering and general technology updates, but in this is an important series as per me, because whatever we are putting so much efforts to study undergrads or 11th 12th classes, but if we are not able to place ourselves into a good location for our graduate or undergraduate studies, then it's of no use. All the hard work is of no use. So over here, I'm going to cover all the aspects required for applications for higher studies or even studies immediately after 12. So that is undergraduate and graduate. So over here, I'm going for abroad higher studies application overview. So for abroad, I majorly means USA and Europe, but I'm going to also cover about Singapore and Japan majorly. And with higher studies, I mean MS, that is Master of Science, which is equivalent to ME degree or MTech degree of India, or MSc degree, and also about PhD, but more of this would be around Master of Science MS and less of PhD, because I have not as of now engaged with PhD. So my friends will come over and they'll help us understand more about the PhD applications. With respect to application overview, we are going to start with day one of how to go ahead with the applications to the day one we are landing in the university. So I'll try to cover all the things, but as we proceed with time, I'll cover one thing at a time. So we have covered all the things in detail as per the requirement. And let me clear with this. I am no expert in this. I have just recently gone ahead with my applications starting last year, and now I have secured my position in Texas A&M University, and I am an alumni of BITS Pilani, India. So I have studied mechanical engineering over here. So maybe the more details when we cover about applications, specific details, then they may be more specific to mechanical engineering. But I'll try and gather more information regarding computer science, chemical engineering, electronic fields, mathematics, and other pure science also, because we have a lot of people from my university itself who are going for abroad studies, and they have a lot of information. They have recently gone through this phase. So let's go ahead. And what I'm going to discuss today, it's only an overview today. So first thing, I'll give you a brief about how to apply, the exact procedure. The second, where do we make the application and submit it? And the third, what do we need in terms of documents and other information for the application? So the first thing you need to do about the application procedure is, first, you need to research about the university. That means you need to know what universities you want to go to for higher studies. Second, you need to shortlist universities. So there could be some 20, 30, 40, maybe 50 universities which may have interested you, but it's not feasible in terms of monetary aspect that you apply to 50 universities, because each university application may require some $100 of application fees. So that 50 into $100 could be a large amount. So you need to shortlist some 5, 10, 15 as per your logistics, interest, and capabilities, and shortlist universities. Third is to start application, and fourth is to submit the application. So the fourth point may not be compulsory for all the university applications. Some university have a deadline of maybe 15th December. So till 15th December, you can make all the changes required, and there is no submit button. You can make changes till the time permits, and the last saved information will be taken for the submitted application. So there's no submit button. Exactly. And after the application is submitted, this can be done before the application is submitted, or you start up the application, and after, upon the time permits and the requirement of the university, you may contact professors. So mail them that you are interested in their research or the courses they are teaching, and make a contact with them. Now, where to apply? So the universities have application portals very similar to what you would have seen after your 12. So if we have a JEE marks, we'll apply to IITs, NIT, IIIT, etc. If we have bid set given, then we'll apply to bids. If we have SRM, IST given, then we are going to apply to SRM. So this universities or colleges in India have a common portal. So all the three campuses of bids in India have a common portal of bids admission. Similarly, for admissions to using JEE marks, we can apply to IIT, NIT, IIIT, and other. So they have a common application portal, which is called was JOSA. So similarly, over here also, universities have common application portals. One of the common portal is Engineering CAS. The second common is Apply Web. And the third is individual portals of university. In the next videos upcoming, I will also go and come up with a special video in which I'll discuss about a common portal which is connected to all the portals of all the universities. So you need to apply or put information, because there is a lot of information you need to put. So you need to put information of your profile only in that common portal, and the same information will be reflected in your all the applications. So that is a shortcut, but it's better you go through individual university application pages, so you can get a better perspective of what all information is required in other universities. Let's look at some of these examples of application portals. So this is the application portal for UCSD. UCSD means University of California, San Diego. And this is the their official website. So it's very important you look at the website and make sure it is legitimate and original. It's not fake. It's not incorrect website. So over here, I have gone through their website and figure out where is their application portal. So this is where Grad Apply comes, and they have made some announcement, and it is informed that there are no programs currently accepting applications. Still, we can go through the application portal. So we can go to the new application portal, and this is how their application portals looks like. Over here, it is the returning user. This is the first time user. So when you want to start a new application, you need to create an account and put your email address and make a new password. And usually they'll also ask for your date of birth. These three things will be usually asked to make a new account. And it is advisable to give your personal email address instead of your university address. Okay. And because the university addresses have .edu.in, so it may get filtered out, or their application, the database may not be able to send you email back. So after you make an account, you will get a confirmation mail from this university to your registered email address that your new account has been created. And if there is a new OTP upcoming, or you need to reset the password, all the information will be sent to your registered email. So it's advisable you make a user personal email address, which you check regularly, because all the updates about this university's application procedure or timeline or any advices they want to give will be emailed to you. So you need to keep them checked in regularly. So this was UCSD. The second example I have is about University of Michigan, Ann Arbor. So UM, Ann Arbor. Over here, I have come to their application portal. So I can click over here, apply now. And it will take me to their application portal. So over here, this is of Apply Web. You can see Apply Web portal has come up. And over here also, they'll ask you to make a new, create a new account. And since I have already a new, older account because I have applied to University of Michigan. So I am having the email address and password, but you need to make a new account. And let's go to Texas A&M, where I have gotten admissions. So over here on their website, they have clearly given all the information about how to apply and all. Let's go to their portal, apply to Engineering CAS. So this is the portal of Engineering CAS. And if you are ready to apply, you can click on this and it will take you to the page where you need to generate an email address, like give an email address, date of birth, and the first password. If the password is not asked, they'll give you a reset password link on your email address. So you can create a new account over here. Okay, so let's get back to our PPT. Now we'll go to a bit of details. I'll not go into a small and minor details of the application, but give you a brief about what all things will come up when you go to this applications portal. Okay, so after you create an account and start with your application, what all information you need to provide is listed over here. The first is the personal information that will include your name and date of birth, the place of birth. So make sure you have your passport ready. You do not use your information in the Aadhaar card, only use the information in your passport. So you need to provide your personal information. Then you need to provide your family background. So about your parents, parents' email address, phone number, your home address, current address, permanent address. There will be a lot of options. Everything will be there. I'll get into all the details of this one by one in the upcoming videos. Then you need to provide your education history. Documents are to be uploaded or essays are to be uploaded. So sometime they'll give you a question and you can type in your text pad, notepad or Google Doc or Word, MS Word, make a PDF and then upload, or in their portal itself, they'll give you a question and there will be a text box below the question and you need to type in your answer over there and it will be saved. So what all the information which you provide over here on the portal, that is saved, or if the otherwise there would be a button to save the information. So it's not compulsory. You provide all the information in one go and submit the applications. It's not required, and you'll see that the application is a long one. It's not easy to be completed in a couple of hours. It takes days. So obviously there are options to save the application and resume your application from the same position ahead. Sometimes it may be things that once you are providing personal information, you cannot change that. But usually I have not found such a thing on any applications portal till now. Then you need to provide information about your research work, work experience or professional experience. So if you have gone and work in any industry, then you provide a professional experience, work experience, and whatever projects, research projects you have done or internships you have done. Internships count in work experience, research projects count in research experience. So all experience other than academic, you can provide over here. Then there could be some miscellaneous questions, such as if you need a financial aid, then they may give you, provide some space to you that give your reasons for application for financial aid. So that means that the application fee, which is $70, $80, $100, that can be waived off for you. So they need a reason why you want an application fee waiver. Okay, and there could be a space where you can upload other documents. So they would have mentioned that if you have any other information to be said, any other documents to be said which are not uploaded yet, so this would be the last step, then you can upload over here, or you can mention any other information over here. Then the last thing would be to pay the fees and submit the application. As I have mentioned earlier, the submitting application may not be there in all the application portals. A few application portals allow you to change all the information or some information till the application deadline, and some other do not. They will have a submit button. And the fee payment part, so make sure you have a credit card which has international payments on, because any fee application, application fee payment can be only done using a credit card. And make sure these credit cards have international payments on, that is the payments done in dollars. And also for your information, these applications, these payments will not get not have any OTPs for you. So once you go ahead and provide all the information and click on the pay button, you will not get any OTP to confirm your payment. That's how they work. Okay, and that's the reason our debit cards or internet, net banking, NEFT, IMPS doesn't work. Okay, so any other information, all the details will be discussed in the upcoming videos. This was the brief overview. In the upcoming videos, I'll give you the application timeline, when to start, what to do at what time, when are the application deadlines, and what to do before application deadline, after application deadline. Everything will be covered, what all tests or exams to be given, what all essays you need to write or letters we need, how to shortlist universities. We have a very useful spreadsheet spreadsheet to maintain the data which we are getting after shortlisting universities when we are going through the application procedures, because there is a lot of information, and then we are working on resume CV. There is much more we can discuss. So that's where I want to add. Keep connected. Okay. Thank you.